Praise the Lord.
Okay,
I
hallelujah.
Said, praise the Lord.
Money,
are
okay,
you
hallelujah.
Happy to be here tonight? The Lord will bless every one of you in Jesus' name. How many of you believe a miracle is waiting for you? Stand on your feet as we pray together. Almighty God, we thank you very much today. Almighty God,
you
know that our Lord Jesus Christ is here.
He's
passing by everyone right now. He has a miracle for everyone. And I pray, Lord, you bless your people today in Jesus' name. Of course, we miss our blessing. I pray today, multitudes be saved in Jesus' name. Those who are sick with any kind of sickness or disease, touch them and heal them in Jesus' name. Any suffering, any sorrow in the heart, I pray, Lord, you'll come down and remove everything in Jesus' name. Bless everyone here tonight. That no one will go away empty-handed. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16. Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16. It says, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. That verse I read to you contains some important words. But I
have
one word I want you to notice. That word comes out twice in that verse. It talks about grace. Number one, it tells us that Almighty God is sitting upon the throne of grace. There is a throne of judgment and there is a throne of grace.
It
says now you can come and you can come boldly. You can come with faith and confidence and trust. And you are coming to the throne of grace. When we talk about grace, we're talking about God's undeserved mercy. We're talking about God's unmerited favor. And that unmerited favor and undeserved mercy is available for you. That's why it says come. Come boldly. You don't have to be timid when you come to the Lord. You don't have to be fearful when you come to the Lord. You don't have to be doubtful when you come to the Lord. But it says you come boldly to the throne of grace. Then it says that we may obtain mercy. It means to receive something. Whenever you come to the Lord, you may come empty handed. You go back home full to obtain the mercy of God. And then it says that we may find grace to help in the time of need. The need may be salvation. The need may be healing. The need may be deliverance. The need may be you have need of a child. It says whatever it is you need. As you come boldly to the throne of grace. Then you will obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. I'm talking to you tonight on the wonders of God's grace. The wonders of God's grace. There are many wonders of the grace of God. And the greatest of all wonders is that God himself should love you. And he wants to bless you tonight. And in the blessing he wants to heal. He wants to save. He wants to deliver. That's the wonder of the grace of God. The wonder wonders of God's grace. That Almighty God will send Jesus Christ to die for you, even you, so that all your sins, all your calamities, all your problems, all the mountains in your life, all the sorrow in your family, all the tears in your life, everything in one single night, He'll wipe everything away. He will do it for you tonight. I said He will do it for you tonight. And 3 points to give you before we pray. Number one, the wonder of His unlimited call. The wonder of His unlimited call.
You know,
when God calls you, He doesn't limit you to the Jew. It doesn't limit you to the white man. It doesn't limit you to the American. It is unlimited. That's why tonight you must be happy. Because of the wonder of His unlimited call. Number two, the wonder of His unmistakable conversion. When God gets hold of you, He changes every negative in your life to become positive. He changes everything that is sorrowful, makes you happy. Changes everything that is sinful, He makes you righteous. You've been going the broad way that leads to hell before, He gets hold of you, He turns you around, and He makes you to focus on heaven. The wonder of His unmistakable conversion. Number three is a wonder of His undeserved cure. You're sick, you want to be healed, you want to be cured. You're afflicted, you want to be delivered. And you're wondering, what am I going to do so that I can have that cure, so I can have that deliverance and that healing? The wonder of all wonders. You don't have to deserve anything. In fact, it is a wonder of His undeserved cure. Look at it. Number one is the wonder of His unlimited call. In Matthew chapter 11 verse 28. Matthew chapter 11 verse 28. Wonder of all wonders. Wherever you are tonight, wherever you have gone before tonight, whatever you have done before tonight, whatever sins you have committed, the wonder of His unlimited call. Come unto me. Here is the Almighty. Here is the supply, the one that can supply all our needs. Here is the one that can redeem us. Here is our Savior. Here is the one that died for us. Here is the one that will take the load of your sin away. And He says, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever the guilt, whatever the condemnation, come unto me. All ye that labor and a heavy laden, and I will give you rest. That means He will give you peace of mind. Are you weak and weary? Come unto Christ. Are you helpless and hopeless? Come unto Christ. Are you tired and dejected? Come unto Christ. Are you dirty and defiled? Come unto Christ. Are you afflicted and attacked? Come unto Christ. Are you sick and suffering? Come unto Christ. Are you oppressed or demonized? Come unto Christ. Are you poor and needy and worthless? Come unto Christ. Christ is calling you. And He says, whoever you are, as He taught Bartimaeus the blind man, arise, He calleth you. As that prodigal son came back home, arise, He calleth you. As Naaman came to Jordan, to the cleansed of his leprosy, come unto Christ. The deepest of sinners, the greatest of sinners, the vilest of sinners, the deadliest of sinners, the Lord does not make any discrimination. The Lord is calling you today. He says, come unto me. me. Come out of your darkness. Come out of your sin. Come out of your adultery. Come out of your idol worship. Come out of your stealing. There is something better in the hand of Christ waiting for you. Come unto me. He says, do it now. Don't wait till tomorrow. Tomorrow may be too late. Or how shall we escape? If we neglect so great salvation, come now. Come believing. Come to Jesus, look and live. Because it's the one that is raised up for you. Because as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so, as the Son of Man being lifted up, that whosoever will believe on him will not perish but have everlasting life. That's why he said, this is your day. I want you to say, this is my day. This is my day. This is my day. That's why he's calling you, come unto him. All ye that labor, you see that it doesn't make any discrimination. You see it is unlimited. You see it is universal. He says, all ye that labor, and you are heavy laden, sin is heavy. It is heavier than stone. It is heavier than cement. When you have been living in sin, your conscience is heavy, your heart is heavy, your mind is heavy, your legs are heavy, your thoughts are heavy, everything about your life is heavy. You cannot carry yourself. It's like a great load is upon you, because sin weighs us down. That's why it says, all that are heavy laden. And then it says, now I will lift up the load. I will take the mountain away. I will take the condemnation away, because there is therefore no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but they walk after the Spirit, because the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free, because being justified by faith, we have peace with God. His name is wonderful. His name is the Prince of Peace. When you come to the Lord, he will take the sin away. He will take the load away. And then he says, I will give you rest. I'll give you peace of mind. You say, can I come? Will he receive me? Will he accept me? With all the bad things I have done. In John chapter 6 and in verse 37. John chapter 6 verse 37. He says, all that the Father giveth me shall come unto me. The Father is laying his hand upon you tonight. That's why the Spirit of the Lord is telling you, tonight, go there and get saved. Tonight, move on and get saved. Tonight, pray to the Lord and have your sins forgiven. The Father has given you to the Lord. And he that cometh unto me, I will in no wise cast out. He will not push you away. He will not reject you. You say, does that mean me? He said, yes, it means you. In Revelation chapter 22, Revelation chapter 22, and the Spirit and the Bride say, come. Heaven is telling you to come. The Bride is telling you to come. The Holy Spirit is nudging your heart, is touching your heart, is pricking you now. Come. Let him that heareth say, come. And him that is a thirst, let him come. And whosoever will, let him come and take of the water of life freely. The Lord is calling you tonight. The Spirit of God is calling you tonight. And the call of God is a universal call. The call of God is an unlimited call. The call of God is an undiscriminating call. The call of God is a call that is calling you. And he says, come. And I can hear you say, I am coming. I am coming. I've been like away for a long time. I've been far away from the Lord for a long time. I didn't have peace of mind for a long time. I didn't have rest in my soul for a long time. Here today, I hear the voice of the Lord, and He's calling me, and He says, come. And I stretch up my hand, and I surrender to the Lord, and I say, yes, Lord, I hear that you are calling me, and when He calls my name, I will be listening, and I will answer, yes, Lord. And today, as you answer, yes, Lord, He will receive you, like the father received the prodigal son. He will wash you, He will cleanse you, He will forgive you, He will take away your sin, and then He's going to do something for you. That leads me to point number two, the wonder of His unmistakable conversion. And there is a kind of thing that happens to somebody when it comes to the Lord. It is called a turning around. It is called a transformation. It is called a mighty change. It is called a supernatural transformation. This is when the blood of Jesus reaches down deep into your very heart and the very corners of your heart and the dirtiest part of your life, the sponge of heaven, the soap of heaven, the detergent of heaven, that no matter the stain, no matter the dirt, no matter the pollution, no matter how corrupt you have been, the touch of the hand of the Almighty recreating you and transforming you, it changes everything completely, and it is called unmistakable conversion. It is called a unique conversion. It is called an undeniable conversion. Look at it in 1 Timothy chapter 1. In 1 Timothy chapter 1, here I read from verse 13. Conversion that is unique. Conversion that is unmistakable. Conversion that is undeniable. In 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 13, who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious, but I obtained mercy. I'm talking about the wonder of His grace. He says, let us come boldly therefore unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find help in the time of need. And here this man, his name was Saul. Before he was converted, he was Saul. When he was a blasphemer, he was Saul. When he was injurious, when he was wicked, when he was violent, when he had hatred, when he had malice, when he went about a destroyer, when he hated Christ, when he didn't love righteousness, when he was in darkness, when he was serving himself, when he was self-willed, he was Saul. He said, I was a blasphemer. And then he tells us, he said, but something happened to me. When you come to Christ, when you rise up tonight, when you raise up your hand tonight, when you surrender to Christ tonight, when you give yourself to Christ tonight, no matter what you have been, your heart has been very sinful, and your heart very dark, and your life very corrupt. But when you come to the Lord, whatever you were before, this man said, I obtained mercy. That's the grace of God. Undeserved, unmerited, but I got it because it is mercy. And remember, it is unlimited. It's available for you tonight. It's available for everyone because it was available for Saul. And then it says in verse 14, and the grace of our Lord was exceeding abundant with grace and love which is in Christ Jesus. The change happened in his life. He became Paul. Paul, a child of God. Paul, a Christian. Paul, a light bearer. Paul, a converted man. Paul, a servant of God. Paul, a son of God. Because it says, he has received him. To them he gave power to become the sons of God. When you receive the Lord Jesus Christ, and you come out of your sin, and you come to the Lord, and you come to the Savior, and himself and said, behold, I stand at the door and I am knocking. If anyone hears my voice and he opens the door, I will come in unto him. When he comes into you, he comes as Savior, he comes as Lord, he comes as Redeemer, he comes as the one to forgive you, he comes as the one to convert you, he comes as the one to change you. When he comes, he comes with grace. When he comes with grace, then you become a converted man. The change will be undeniable. The change will be unmistakable. That's what the man said. Look at verse 15. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. There is a lot there. A sinner is like a boy that fell into the well, and the ground of the well is very slippery. All the time the boy was making to come up, he would slip and get into the bottom, into the depth of the well again. He will cry, he will make resolution, he will determine, he will say, no, I will not remain here, I will come out myself. He tries again, he gets back into the well again. Until now, the dirty water in the well is all over his body, and the dirty water in the well is inside his stomach, and then he begins to give up. I cannot do anything, I cannot save myself. Then he begins to cry out, I am lost, I am lost, I am lost. Then the hand of mercy comes from outside, comes from above, and reaches down very, very long, and it says, hold it. And then he holds it, and that powerful hand, that mighty hand, pulls him up. I'm talking about you tonight. I'm talking about you, the sinner. I'm talking about you, the dirty one. I'm talking about you that fell into the well of sin. And you tried. All resolutions you made, all attempts that you made, all determination that you made, you couldn't save yourself until you began to cry out.